What's going on, guys? It's Sinju in Japan here. I'm sure you're excited for the new Demon Slayer game, but what type of netcode does it really have? Let's try to figure that out together. So I'm going to go ahead and start this off by saying the new Demon Slayer game is being developed by CC2, that is CyberConnect 2, and they're responsible for the games such as the Naruto Storm series, Ashura's Wrath, Dragon Ball Kakarot, and that's just something to say the least. Now that we're caught up on who they are, I can let you guys know what it's like to play a Storm game online and what the netcode is like. Now, CyberConnect 2 implements what most fighting games use, which is peer-to-peer netcode servers. Oh, and shout out to Hayate Maru from the Steam community, man. You really helped me with the info. Basically, what peer-to-peer is that the interactions are going through a host server, not your own. And most games do this because it's easier to not have a middleman. Now see, peer-to-peer can cause delay. Now that's all good and fine for like RPGs or shooters because they don't need exact positioning to be accurate. But with fighting games, that's another story. With fighting games, let's use Storm 4 for example, it does need to know your square, triangle, circle, and X positioning. But since there is a delay when the buttons are pushed, it doesn't sync correctly with your character. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but I hate it when I get a miss input on these type of games and then I know I'm pressing a button and it's still not reacting how it should be. It kind of makes you feel like... Yeah, don't do that. Alright, moving on. So you're probably asking yourself, why should I care about this? I got the new Demon Slayer game coming out and you feel like you're all good. Well, not necessarily. You're going to want to play on the best connection that they could possibly put in. And if you want to go bigger and better for a fighting game, you're going to want to have Rollback Netcode. And I'm guessing you're probably asking, what is that? Well, it's a netcode that basically guesses the intended input before you even make it. And when the input arrives late, it corrects it, pretty much replays, and then acts like it happened on time. Now that sounds like a server I could get by. Now this would be amazing if CC2 was ever planning on implementing this into the game. Plus, I don't think there's a 3D arena fighter that has this implemented already, so that would be a pretty cool first. But see, that's a big if. They have to make it a part of the game while they're developing it. They can't just add it in later as an update or an installment. It just won't work that way. Hey, but it is a possibility that it could make it into the game. They have other games right now being made, like Guilty Gear Strive, for example. That game's beta had a massively successful beta, like it was amazing. The netcode worked perfectly fine. And of course I want the same thing to happen for Demon Slayer Hinokami Kaputan. I'm sure everybody wants to go into ranked battles with a good connection, you know, stable connectivity. Nobody likes it when it like really starts stuttering or it gives you a game crash. Nobody wants that. I know I don't. But yeah guys, that's just a couple things I wanted to address, you know, some things that I wanted to come to the game as far as connectivity or the server goes. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys think or want server wise. I know I'm not a genius at the topic, so I'm pretty sure there's a lot you guys have to add to the topic as well. But hey, that pretty much wraps up the video. I appreciate you guys for watching. And if you like the video, then like the video. It's your boy Sinju in Japan. I'll see you soon.